In today's video, you will learn about the most common signs and symptoms, but also causes of iron deficiency anemia. Anemia occurs when there are not enough healthy red blood cells to carry oxygen to your body's tissues and organs. And we also have different, you know, types of anemia, but the most common type is iron deficiency anemia. Initially, iron deficiency anemia can be so mild that it can really go unnoticed for weeks, if not months. But as your body becomes more and more deficient in iron and anemia worsens, the signs and symptoms intensify. Iron deficiency anemia signs and symptoms may include things like, for example, extreme fatigue, weakness, pale skin, chest pain, having a fast heartbeat, also having, you know, shortness of breath, having headache, dizziness, lightheadedness, so, you know, kind of brain fog, also cold hands, cold feet, inflammation or soreness of your tongue, brittle nails, and also hair loss. Also, one of the weird really signs and symptoms is having a craving for substances like, for example, ice or starchy foods like, for example, potatoes or rice. Or in children, you can also see very, you know, strange kind of signs. It's a poor appetite. So if you're having an infant or child with iron deficiency anemia, they will not have a big appetite. The biggest cause of iron deficiency anemia in thyroid disease, but not really, you know, only in thyroid disease. This can also happen, you know, if you don't suffer from thyroid disease, but in thyroid disease it's more common. It's low stomach acid. Now, in thyroid disease, it's already super common to have low stomach acid. And if you don't have enough stomach acid, it's very challenging for your body to digest, you know, proteins, particularly animal proteins, and thereby compromising your, you know, natural absorption of iron from these foods. And it's also more challenging for your body to absorb things like, for example, vitamin B12 and zinc as well. Another trigger and, you know, slash cause which may contribute to deficiency in iron is low vitamin C intake. If you don't eat foods high in vitamin C, like for example leafy greens or meat, you automatically compromise your absorption of iron. This is because you need vitamin C to properly absorb iron. Low selenium intake may also impair functional iron status as it contributes to the formation of methemoglobin, which contains ferric iron, which is Fe3+ instead of normal, you know, form of iron, which is Fe2+. And in this way, it's unable to, you know, being carried inside your body and also to carry oxygen to the tissues. So we have a problem with transport. Iron from food is absorbed into your bloodstream from small intestine. So also that's why if you have a problem in your small intestine, this can also be, you know, more difficult for you to absorb iron. So, you know, things like, for example, celiac disease, SIBO, or any other GI issue can automatically, like, you know, impair your ability to absorb nutrients from your food. So not only iron, but also, you know, other nutrients. And this can also lead to iron deficiency anemia. Another cause is, of course, blood loss. Blood contains iron within the red blood cells. So if you lose blood, you automatically lose some iron. And women with heavy periods are more at risk of, you know, iron deficiency anemia because they lose blood during menstruation. So if you are a woman and you are afraid of, you know, having iron deficiency anemia, you have to make sure that you supplement with more iron and also check your iron more often than, for example, men. Also, slow and chronic blood loss within your body, like for example, peptic ulcers, or for example, hiatal hernia, or colon polyps, or for example, colorectal cancer, can also cause iron deficiency anemia. Also, gastrointestinal bleeding, can also cause iron deficiency anemia. Usually it's caused from overdose of aspirin. So if you've been taking tons of aspirin and you've been having some bleeding, make sure to consult it with a doctor because this is something more severe. But this can also put you at risk of having iron deficiency anemia. Another reason, this one is actually very common, is having iron deficiency anemia from your diet. If you are, you know, having a diet which is depleted from any, you know, iron sources, like for example leafy greens, but also meat, over time your body can become iron deficient. So examples of iron-rich foods would include, you know, meat, eggs, leafy green veggies, like for example kale and spinach. So make sure to consume these ones. Also, another important thing to keep in mind is that if part of your small intestine has been, you know, bypassed or maybe removed surgically, this also may affect your ability to absorb iron and also other nutrients. So in this case, you may need to supplement with higher doses of iron. But again, preferably, you know, consult with a doctor who follows you. He or she will, you know, should give you the proper indications and also the proper dose that you should be taking and supplementing. And the last common cause of iron deficiency anemia is pregnancy. Without iron supplementation, iron deficiency anemia occurs in many pregnant women because their iron stores need to serve not only for themselves but also for the developing baby. So if you're pregnant, make sure that you have enough iron. And the way to check it is with the iron studies but also with ferritin levels. If your ferritin levels are somewhere, you know, on the like lower end of the range, of the ferritin range, this means that you are deficient in iron. So make sure to supplement with iron just to help yourself and also your developing baby. Anyways, guys, that's everything. If you have any questions, make sure to comment below and make sure to also watch this video. In this video, you will learn more about the thyroid disease. And in the next video, I will give you more tips about iron deficiency, which supplements are the best, when to supplement, and which labs you have to check to, you know, understand if you are deficient in iron. Thanks for watching and see you in the next video.